A good understanding of the cue button and the primary cue point within your song is fundamental to getting the best out of Torq 2.0. Each deck in Torq has a cue button located on the transport, directly above the play pause button. Now the cue button will look different with a track loaded onto a deck from the browser, one in deck B and one in deck C. Now the first time you add a song to a deck, it gets analyzed for tempo and beat information, and once complete the cue button will light up. Now pressing and holding the cue lets you hear the primary cue point. Let it go and it returns to that point. In the case of these two songs, that's right at the very beginning. Not the best place for a cue point. So I need to establish the best turntable starting point, or where the needle drops. And I want the drop point to be right here, right on the downbeat. Let me zoom in so it's easier for you to see. Now you can see that the cue button is now flashing. This indicates that your needle position is different from the primary cue point. If you press the cue button while it's flashing, a new primary cue point will be written. Here it is in red. To get back to it, play the deck and then hit the cue button. It will stop flashing and allow you to audition it. Now remember that normally you'd be doing this with the deck volume down and you'd be using your headphones. Now I'm going to go ahead and cue up from that downbeat. Now I don't need to be too particular about where I place the needle position in reference to the downbeat, just to the left. I can use the quantize function that's built into Torq to compensate for this gap and then cue me right on beat. Nice. Remember, if cue is flashing, hit play, then the cue button to return to the primary cue point. Fantastic. So let's recap while we zone out on Robot Apocalypse. Here we go, deck C, volume down, PFL, or cue the sound to the headphones. I'm gonna click on the waveform, then shuttle back. So there's my drop point, but my phase grid is off by one beat and I need to fix that. The white line should be right here. Hold down shift, grab the phase grid and slip it until it's on a downbeat. Now I can cue the deck close enough and then hit the cue button to write the primary cue point. Audition it. Perfect. Now I can just sync the deck and off we go. With deck C playing, I can stop deck B, return to the cue point, and drop it back in the mix. Deck C, back to cue. Nice. Now, once a song has a primary cue point, Torq will remember that. So when you're playing another routine at a club, cue it quickly and get it into the mix. Nice.